Welcome to the next class, How to Use a Dictionary, Unit 3, Chapter 7. What is a dictionary? Dictionary means a book or electronic resource that lists the words of a language, typically in alphabetical order, and gives their meaning or gives the equivalent words in a different language, often also providing information about pronunciation, origin, and usage. A good dictionary is an essential tool for any language learner. It can, however, be difficult to use, and not all language learners fully understand how a dictionary works or the best type to use. This section will consider different types of dictionary and the advantages and disadvantages of each, as well as looking at the features of a good dictionary. It concludes by looking at ways to improve dictionary use. Okay, this is a practice activity, pre-reading activity. What do you do when you come across a difficult word or a phrase? This question to you. So if this question to me, then I answer, definitely I refer the dictionary. Next question. What do you do when you do not know the appropriate word to describe something? If I am asked this question, definitely I say I refer dictionary as well as a thesaurus. Next, what do you do when you want to know the pronunciation of a word? My answer is definitely I refer dictionary. What do you expect from a dictionary? So based on the above questions, I expect from the dictionary meanings, pronunciation, finding appropriate word, etc. Next, activity 1. Read the following episodes and guess the meaning of the words given at the end of each episode. The question is clear. Guess the meaning of words given at the end of each episode. First one. Two boys were arguing when their grandfather entered the room. Grandfather says, "Why are you arguing?" One boy answers, "We found a $10 bill." That means it is using US word. We can consider it as a $10 currency note. "We found a $10 bill and decided to give it to whoever tells the biggest lie." "You should be ashamed of yourself," said the grandfather. "When I was of your age, I did not even know what a lie was." The boys gave the $10 to the grandfather immediately. Okay, now guess the meanings of the given words: argue, bill, lie, ashamed. Okay, I think you guessed the meaning. Now I give you the real answer, what it is means. Argue. Argue means exchange or express diverging or opposite views, different views, thoughts, sharing different thoughts. Typically in a heated or angry way, seriously. Next, bill. Bill means a printed or written statement of the money owed for goods or services. In one more meaning, a bank note. There are different meanings are there. Next, lie. Generally, lie has two meanings. One is be in or assume a horizontal or resting position on a supporting surface. Sleeping in the mode of a sleeping. When you sleep, you lie down on the bed like that. Next one is a false statement made with the deliberate intent to deceive. An intentional untruth. So the actual answer is second one in the discussion. Okay. One more is there. Ashamed, you identify it. Next, a man goes to the doctor and says, "Doctor, wherever I touch, it hurts." The doctor asks, "What do you mean?" The man says, "When I touch my shoulder, it really hurts. When I touch my knee, ouch. When I touch my forehead, it really, really hurts." The doctor says, "I know what's wrong with you. You have broken your finger. The problem is not in your body. The problem is in your finger. The finger is broken." Okay, here, hurt, knee, forehead, ouch. Guess the meaning. Okay. I give the meanings from the dictionary. When you read any paragraph, when you are trying to learn new words, don't hurry, don't go for dictionary always. Don't try to get the meaning, don't try to learn the meaning from the dictionary. First try, guess the meaning. Okay, hurt. To cause bodily pain to or in. To cause bodily injury to. Injure. Next, knee. The joint of the leg that allows for movement. For movement. Movement means moving. One. Okay. Forehead. The part of the face above the eyebrows. Bro. Next, ouch. Used as an exclamation expressing sudden pain or dismay. Dismay means pain. Okay. Here, dictionary means, according to the chapter, a dictionary is a reference book containing a list of words of a language arranged in alphabetical order along with the information about them. It helps the learners understand various words and developing their vocabulary. Dictionaries come in all shapes and sizes. Some of them are little dictionaries, school dictionaries, pocket dictionaries, concise dictionaries, compact dictionaries, mini dictionaries, and advanced learners dictionaries. So here, in your examination point of view, you get one mark question or three mark question, what is dictionary? Then you have to write this answer. Dictionary is a reference book containing list of words of a language arranged in alphabetical order along with information about them. what are the different types of dictionaries? Then little dictionary, school dictionary, pocket dictionary, concise dictionary, compact dictionary, mini dictionary, advanced learners dictionaries, in that way. Next, kinds of dictionaries. In your examination, 3 marks or 5 marks question, generally this question comes. Write the different kinds of dictionaries. Explain the different kinds of dictionaries. There are several kinds of dictionaries available in the market. Some dictionaries are used for general purpose, some dictionaries for scholarly purpose, and some other are for specialized purpose. Each dictionary is compiled with a particular set of users in mind for a specific purpose. Some medical students, they use specific dictionary. Some law, related to law, they use law dictionary. Mathematics, mathematics dictionary, computer, computer dictionary. So the major kinds of dictionaries are, number one, general dictionary. It is useful for all. It gives the general meaning or meaning of a word. Example, Oxford Dictionary of English. Next, specialized dictionary. It focuses on a specific subject area. Example, Merriam-Webster's medical dictionary. So all medical terminology words are there in the dictionary. Some words may not be available in general dictionary. So that those words available in medical dictionary. Next, etymological dictionary. In your examination, one more question may ask, what is etymological dictionary? What is there? What will be there in the etymological dictionary? It describes the origin and development of a word. Origin and development of a word. How it was origin, was developed. Origin. How it was coined, the word. Who coined the word? How it was coined? And what purpose it was coined? Created. So most of the large dictionaries provide the etymological information of a word. However, there are a few dictionaries exclusively designed for providing etymological information. One example, Oxford Dictionary of English Etymology. Etymology. Oxford Dictionary of English Etymology. Next one, illustrated dictionary. It is not just about words. It contains pictures. It is useful to the children in visualizing the concept. Sometimes we may not understand the meaning exactly, but when we see the picture, we clearly understand it. So generally kids, children use illustrated dictionaries. So in our private Telegram channel, I have provided a number of illustrated dictionaries related number different areas. So you can go there, refer, join the my personal Telegram channel. I will write here the name. Telegram channel. So if you search by the given phrase, you will see one Telegram channel. The deep photo is, you will see my name, Niranjan, in DP. Okay. Reverse dictionary. It is also available in our Telegram channel, Reverse Dictionary, Oxford Reverse Dictionary. It helps the reader to find the appropriate word by describing the concept. you know the concept, but you don't know the exact word, then you can identify that word by following the reverse dictionary. Next, bilingual dictionary. Bi means two, lingual means language, two language dictionary. It gives the meanings of words in a specified language. Example, English, English, Telugu dictionary, published by D. Bose and Bros. One example only, this is. Next, rhyming dictionary. In this dictionary, words are categorized into equivalent classes that consist of words that rhyme with one another. It is useful in writing poetry and lyrics. Example, Merriam-Webster's rhyming dictionary. Next, monolingual or explanatory dictionary. It gives a detailed explanation of a word with additional information. It is useful to the advanced learners or the native speakers of that language. Example, Oxford Advanced Learners Dictionary, Langman Dictionary of Contemporary English, or Collins Co-Build English Dictionary, or Cambridge Advanced Learners Dictionary. Only English. Okay. Next, Thesaurus. It is a dictionary of synonyms and antonyms. You get the number of synonyms. Suppose fear. Fear is the word. You want to get the synonyms of fear, afraid, scared, frightened. There are number of words will be there in the same place. Next, the example, Oxford Thesaurus of English. You will get this. You can get download. You can download this from our Telegram channel. Next, electronic dictionary. It is latest trend, mobiles and laptops. It is in digital form. It is available on the internet or World Wide Web, www. And can be accessed through a web browser. It also can be installed on a desktop computer or laptop or mobile. Example, Merriam-Webster Online Dictionary. Next, idioms dictionary. It describes the metaphorical meaning of an idiom. How we use the word. So metaphorical means metaphors. In figures of speech, simile, metaphor, oxymoron, like that number of figures of speech are there. In that, metaphor means comparison. So generally, these metaphors we see in poems, songs. He is the lion in the battle, in that way. He is like a lion in the battle, is simile. Okay. Langman Idioms Dictionary is one example. Next, pronunciation dictionary. It gives the phonetic transcription of the words. How to pronounce a word, that is. Example, Langman Pronunciation Dictionary. There are number of dictionaries are there. Next, Encyclopedia Dictionary. It discusses a wide range of topics arranged alphabetically. Example, the Oxford Encyclopedic English Dictionary. Everything will be there with the general knowledge also. General information. Next, activity 2. Do you have a dictionary at home? If your answer is yes, describe it in a couple of sentences. How is your dictionary? So you have to describe it because you have the dictionary, your dictionary. Next, if your answer is no, which dictionary you would like to buy? Give the reasons. Okay, I have given some model answer here. My dictionary is very big. Words are arranged in alphabetical order. It gives spellings, pronunciation, parts of speech, synonyms, antonyms, and usage in sentence form. That means Oxford Advanced Learners Dictionary. Suppose if I want to buy one more dictionary, I will buy the same, that kind of dictionary only. If anybody asks me, please suggest me one good dictionary, then I say Oxford Advanced Learner's Dictionary. Next, which dictionary would you like to buy if you want to present a dictionary to your sister who is in 8th class? Give the reasons. Generally, 8th class standard advanced learner's dictionary is not suitable. They may not follow. So Oxford dictionary, standard dictionary is enough. So that is the reason. Next. Okay, we have the dictionary. We purchased the dictionary. Now, how to use the dictionary? How to locate a word in a dictionary? So this is very, very important question in your 3 marks question, 1 mark question, 5 mark questions. In everywhere you see this question. Without this question, you will not get the question paper. That is the standard of the question. So if you miss this part, you miss the marks. Ultimately, there is no other way. Clear, it is clear. You lose the marks if you do not concentrate on this topic. So how to locate a word, okay? How to locate a word in a dictionary? It is a skill. Locating a word is not a theory subject. It is a skill subject. It is a skill that you need to practice. You need to know the spelling of a word first, okay, before you locate it. If you don't know the spelling, you cannot locate it forever. Because hundreds and thousands of pages, lakhs of words are there. When you come across a difficult word while reading, remember the spelling first. If you want to refer the dictionary, first remember the spelling. But the problem arises when you listen to a difficult word. That means you are not reading, you are listening something. You are listening to somebody. Somebody is speaking, you are listening. There is a word, difficult word you identified. If you don't know the spelling, the problem starts. Okay. You have to guess the spelling of a word first. First thing is you have to guess the spelling. If you don't guess the spelling, you cannot do that. So guessing the spelling of a word may lead you to wrong sections of the dictionary. If you cannot guess the spelling properly, you cannot get it. You cannot identify it forever. So here are some examples. They may lead you wrong way. Guessing. Actually, the spelling is P-S-Y-C-H-E. If you don't know the pronunciation, generally you say psyche. But you see, it is psyche. Psyche means mind. Okay? Not. This is G-N-A-T, gnat. Not G-N-A-T, gnat. Not. Okay? Next, repertoire, not repertoire, rendezvous, not rendezvous, rendezvous. Okay, next, it will be difficult to guess the word if it has silent letters in it. Another problem. I-S-L-A-N-D, Iceland, not Iceland, Island. K-N-U-C-K-L-E, not knuckle, K silent. P-S-A-L-M, not psalm, salam, psalm, that is psalm, devotional song, psalm. Okay. You can notice two words at the top of each page. If you see the dictionary, you understand it. You can notice two words at the top of each page, left and right on the top page, page top side. Okay. These words are called guide words. These words give you an indication of how close you are while locating your ward. If your ward not near to the two wards, so you may not get the correct word. You may not identify the word in that phase. Clear? The word you are searching for is between these two guide words. Now, use the second letter of the word to run down the page and locate the word. Run down the page using these two letters till you find the word you are searching for. You can easily locate the word as the words are given in alphabetical order. So that is why alphabetical order is very important. Dictionary without alphabetical order, that is nonsense. Next example, how to locate a word. Just example. If you want to find out the meaning of the word syllable, first go to S section of the dictionary. Alphabetical S. Next, look at the top of the each page in that section and observe the guide words. Guide words. Your word will be between those guide words. Go to the page with the guide words. Swap. Sympathy. So in between you get the syllable word. Okay. The word syllable comes between these two words. Now use the second letter of the word to run down the page and locate the word. Why is the second letter in the word syllable? Run down the page using these two letters till you find the word you are searching for. You find the word syllable. Image of a page in Oxford Learner's Dictionary in which syllable word is given. So guide words and the head word, that means syllable. I'm not giving the picture because of copyright issues. Okay. Next, here is an activity. Locate the following words in the dictionary and mention the page number beside the word between the parentheses, brackets. In this bracket, you have to write polytechnic, in which page the word is there. You have to open the dictionary and identify the word and write the page number. You have to do it. Next, pike, idiom, collocation, spelling, phonetic, countable, phrase, concise, etymology. Next, second one. Arrange the following words in the alphabetical order. Arranging alphabetical order, you know. It's very simple. Machine, marriage, material, marine, material, mountain, market, memory, muscle, mockery. So from all these, which word comes first? Guess. So for all words have first letter M. Some words have first second letter A. So the word which has second letter A will come first. So here, machine, marriage, material, marine, material, market, these words are there. Then we have to move to third word. C, machine, C, marriage, R, material, T, marine, material, market. Yes, exactly, we found. Machine is the first word in the alphabetical order. First word comes. Okay, you have to write here. Next, basic uses of dictionary. What are the uses of dictionary? This question comes. If you don't get the previous question in examination, then definitely you will get the second question, this question. There is no leaving. This is sure question. So, basic uses of dictionary means what are the benefits of using dictionary? First one is how to locate a word dictionary. Second one is what are the benefits of learning dictionary. Okay. What are the benefits? If you use the dictionary, if you refer the dictionary, what are the things you will learn? First one is spellings. From the dictionary, you learn spelling. You can learn the spelling of the given word in British English. If there is a difference in spelling in American English, some dictionaries will give the spelling of the same word in American English too. Example, valor. In US, the spelling is valor, V-A-L-O-R. In British, V-A-L-O-U-R. We follow British English, not American English. So, color, C-O-L-O-U-R, color. C-O-L-O-R, color is American. Okay, next. Syllables, we learn. We learn syllables from the dictionary. Syllables means the sound, sound of a vowel. Okay, syllable is a unit of sound that consists of a vowel sound in a word. It helps us pronounce the word well. Perfect pronunciation. For perfect pronunciation, it will help. Dictionary tells us how a word can be broken into syllables. Dictionary helps us. The syllables are separated with a dot, full stop. Example, logically. So in this word, two syllables are there. So the words are separated with dot. So logically, logically. Next, technical, three words, three syllables. Technical, technical. Next, quincentenary, quincentenary, quincentenary. Quincentenary. Quincentenary means 500 years. Centenary means 100 years. Quincentenary, 500. Next, pronunciation. The pronunciation of a word is given between slant marks in phonetic transcription. It tells us how to pronounce the word and its forms. If you don't pronounce, if you don't spell, sound it properly, if you don't use correct pronunciation, other person may not understand. Okay, that is the problem. Example, genuine, charisma, genuine, charisma. Next, word class. Dictionary provides the information about the word family or word class. That means, word class means parts of speech and family division of a word. Suppose, dichotomy. Dichotomy is a singular word, noun. Plural, if you add es, ies, it becomes plural. Dichotomies. Next, die, d-i-a, die. That is verb intransitive. Verb present form, die. Past form, died. Past participle, died. And present continuous, that means present participle, is dying. Tall is adjective. Positive tall compared to taller, superlative tallest. Long, adverb. Taller, sorry, long, longer, longest. So this is word class, parts of speech and its division. Next, meaning. The meaning of a word will be given in English in a word or a phrase or a sentence. Meaning of a word will be given in English in a word or a phrase or a sentence. Bilingual dictionaries give the meaning in the specified language also. Example, talent. Talent means natural power to do something well. Preview. A view of a film before releasing the film. Okay, next, play, etc. Before it is shown to the general public. Next, activity 4. use the dictionary, a dictionary, and give the above mentioned features of the following words. Above mentioned the features means spelling, syllables, pronunciation, word class, meaning. So you have to give all the details to the following words. The words are phrase, etymology, illustration, native, accumulate. These are the words. I have given here one model example. Remaining you have to do. Phrase pronunciation, phrase, F-R-E, that is phrase. Word class is noun. Singular is phrase, plural is phrases. Next, grammatical meaning, a sequence of two or more words arranged in a grammatical construction and acting as a unit in a sentence. Example usage, that means example. A memorable, catchy phrase. Next, synonyms. Phrase synonyms, term, phrase, expression, idiom. Next, origin. Mid-16th century, in the sense, style or manner of expression. By a late Latin from Greek, phrases, from phrasin. Phrase means declare, tell. Next, write the details of the word class and family division of the following words. Clever, simple, formula, forget, child. So family division and word class. I explained just. So suppose clever. Clever is, word class is adjective. So its family is, words are, clever is adjective, clever, positive, cleverer compared to, cleverest is superlative. So origin, Middle English in the sense of to catch hold and related to cleave, to stick to something. Next, third one. How many syllables do the following words have? Mention the number beside the word between the parentheses. So sleep. Sleep has only one syllable. Okay. Bamboo, two. Communication, five. Insist, two. Eliminate, four. Visitor, three. Occupation, four. Imagine, three. Politician, four. Lavish. So if you have some more words, wants to check their syllables, you can check them directly in the given website link. Here I have given, say I'm sharing website link, howmanysyllables.com, www.howmanysyllables.com website is there, only for syllables purpose. Next, what is syllable? Syllable is a unit of pronunciation having one vowel sound with or without surrounding consonants. Maybe consonants are there or not. Okay, leave it. Forming the whole or a part of a word. For example, there are two syllables in water and three in inferno. Inferno means hell. Next, activity five. Identify the words for the following description. Identify the words. Here the description is given. That means reverse dictionary. This is called a reverse dictionary. A piece of glass or glass-like substance with one or both sides curved. Curved means neatly removed with a sharp knife or something. For use in spectacles, cameras, telescopes, and other optical instruments. So mirror, lens, tube, illuminators, all are glasses, okay. But specifically, which one suitable? Lens, okay. Thick, sweet liquid made from sugarcane juice or by boiling sugar with water. So that is called juice, beverage, syrup, honey, you know, all. Beverage means maybe alcohol or cool drinks, something. So juice is the right answer. Next, faint half light before sunrise or after sunset. Faint means light, slide of light. So that is called bright sunshine, darkness, twilight. Twilight is the right answer. Next, having the tendency to go back to the normal or previous size or shape after being pulled or pressed. Elastic, plastic, rubber, stretch. So the suitable word is elastic. Substance obtained during the manufacture of some other substance. So suppose, take one example of wood. If you want to make tables, windows, doors, you need wood. So before cutting into suitable shape, while cutting the wood, you get some particles, powder like wood. So that is called second product. So substance obtained during the manufacture of some other substance. So residue, precipitation, mixture, byproduct. The correct answer is byproduct. Okay, sugar, jaggery, sugar, some other pulp, something, everything. So they come all one by one. Next, movable part of the helmet covering the face, belt, glass, visor, cover. You know, glass is right answer. Okay, next. Advanced functions of a dictionary. What are the functions of dictionary? So first, from the dictionary, we get usage. From advanced dictionaries, we get usage. Some, if you use small dictionary, standard dictionary, you may not get all the things whatever I am going to tell. But advanced learner's dictionary, Oxford-like dictionary, you get all these things, functions. First one is usage. Suppose you know die, word. Die means death. Okay. Like that, you have to use in a sentence. If you use in a sentence correctly, you will learn it proper. So here, you can find several examples on how to use a word in a phrase or a sentence. Example, pedal. Pedal, cyclists. Pedal, boats. So the boy pedaled away on his tricycle. Next, collocation. So some words come generally with some other combining words. So it's a sequence of two or more words that go together. Generally, they come together. You should learn collocations to make your English sound fluent and natural. Suppose beauty. Example, word beauty. Collocations with the word beauty are beauty queen, beauty contest, beauty parlor, beauty spot, beauty sleep, in that way. Next, other forms of the word. So other forms means you can find other parts of speech, forms of the given word, adjective, adverb, preposition, conjunction, noun, in that way. Suppose periodic. Periodic. The two forms of this word are periodical, adjective, and periodically, adverb. Other forms. Die is word. Death is word. Die and death. Death is noun. Die is verb. In that way. Happy. This word has two forms. Happily is adverb. Happiness is noun. Next, etymology. So, etymology, you can find the origin of the word with the important details like language from which this word originated and the period in which it originated. It also provides the information about the way in which its meanings have changed throughout history. So three to four points are mentioned here, etymology. So origin, from which language it was first originated? In which period? In 16th century, 17th century, 18th century, 14th century, 12th century? In which century? In which year? Around year. It also provides information about the way in which its meanings have changed throughout history. Sometimes meanings will be changed from one to another. Example, bandicoot. Origin is from a Telugu word, pandikokku, in late 18th century. So Britishers came to India and some came to Andhra. You know, Andhra also under the colonization of British. So first time they observed one animal. So they asked what it is, the native people, Telugu people. They said pandikokku. So the Britishers unable to pronounce correctly, instead of pandikokku, they said bandicoot. So in that way, bandicoot entered into the dictionary as pandikokku. Next, phyzamas. Phy means leg. Phyzama. In Urdu, phy means leg. Phy is an Urdu word and zama is clothing. So it is a Persian word. This word has been originated in early 19th century. Okay, next, phrasal verbs. You can find phrasal verbs also in a dictionary. Phrasal verb is a phrase consisting of a verb and another element, typically either an adverb or a preposition or both. These phrases give a new meaning other than the meaning of the individual words. So if you see the word individually, it gives one meaning. If you connect them, then the meaning will be changed. New meaning will come. So suppose example, verb plus adjective. Example, verb plus adjective. Go is verb, ahead is adverb. Go ahead, make progress, proceed without hesitation. Next, verb plus preposition, get plus through. Get individual meaning one different and through individual meaning is another one different. But if you combine get and through, it becomes get through. The new meaning is pass. Next, verb plus adverb plus preposition. Play around with. The three has different meanings individually, but if you combine them, it has a new meaning. The meaning is to consider various ways of doing something before choosing one. Next, idioms. These are phrases or expressions which have figurative meaning. These idioms give a meaning which is different from the literal definition. Literal, actual meaning is different. Assumed meaning, the idiomatic meaning is different. So the literal meaning is different. So literal definition of the individual words. It is a manner of speaking that is natural to native speakers of a language. Example, can't judge a book by its cover. You see this sentence phrase in a Ariel advertisement, Ariel washing powder advertisement. They say, yes, okay, we can establish one factory here, but there is no one here to speak English, good English. Then one girl comes, excuse me, sir, don't judge the book by its cover. So remember it. Remember the example, advertisement. So can't judge a book by its cover. The actual meaning is different to idiomatic meaning. So cannot judge something primarily on appearance. Don't come to judgment. Don't judge anything with the appearance. Just watching it, yes, he's innocent. Don't say he's innocent, just watching him. Maybe he's a very criminal, notorious criminal. Okay, next. Let the cat out of the bag. That means to share information that was previously concealed. Concealed means hidden. Next. Apart from the above functions, dictionaries sometimes give illustrations, synonyms, antonyms, labels like obsolete, archaic, colloquial, slang, etc. Next, activity 6. Use a dictionary and give the meanings of the following idioms. Use them in your own sentences. You have to get the meaning, idiomatic meaning, and you have to use your own sentence. See here, have swallowed a dictionary. Wild goose chase, hit the sack, once in a blue moon, storm in a teacup, fit as a fiddle. So I have given one example. To use an extensive vocabulary, especially by incorporating common words in one speech. He has swallowed dictionary. That means he speaks fluently in English. He uses words spontaneously. Okay, you can get answers from the website here given, idioms.thefreedictionary.com. You can get the meanings and examples. Some more, you can check them. Next, find out the etymological information of the following words: avatar, bangla, committee, dacoit, nirvana, jungle, grass. So to get the etymological information of the words, you can directly online, you can check them online website, etymoonline.com, www.etymoonline.com. So I give you one example, avatar. Avatar is a noun. In 1784, a descent of Hindu deity to earth in a incarnate or tangible form. From Sanskrit, avatarana, descent of a deity to the earth in incarnate form. From ava means off, down. From pie root, off, away, plus base of tarati, that means he, crosses over. From pie root, tere, cross over, pass through, overcome, meaning concrete embodiment of something abstract. He is from 1815. In computer use, it seems to trace the novel Snow Crash, 1992, by Neil Stephenson. Next, write the other parts of speech, forms of the following words. Other parts of speech. Normal. Normal is noun as well as adjective. In that way, restrict, punctual, manage, fault, furtive, trivial, in that. So to get the other parts of speech easily, you can go online website, wordsmith.net. Next, tips regarding this chapter. Read the introduction immediately after buying a dictionary. If you have the dictionary, just immediately open it and read the introduction. What this says. Use different dictionaries at different stages. When you are in the 8th class, 9th class, use one kind of dictionary. When you are intermediate stage, use another kind of dictionary. When you are studying diploma, that means engineering course, use a separate dictionary. And when you are studying medicine, you can use a different. In that way, when you are studying law, use law dictionary. Next, don't use the dictionary too much. This is very important. Try to guess meaning from context as much as you can. And then use your dictionary to confirm your guesses afterwards. First guess the meaning, then confirm it. but don't open immediately every time. That is wrong. Next, learn how to use an online dictionary, how to check online websites. Okay, next, update your online dictionary at regular intervals to know the latest entries. Online dictionary or offline dictionary, mobile apps, computer softwares, every year they update and they enter new words. Every dictionaries, Oxford dictionary, something Langman, like that. Do not try to guess the pronunciation of the word. Don't do this. Just before I said, don't check dictionary every time. But here, don't try to guess the pronunciation of the word yourself. Learn it from a standard dictionary. Next assignment. Listen to the news in English and pick out any 10 difficult words and phrases. Guess the spelling of those words and locate them in your dictionary. And maintain one separate notebook for vocabulary and write them. Write the pronunciation, parts of speech, your meaning, usage, collocations, origin, word origin, everything. Write them. And every now and then refer them every day. Next assignment 2. Read the following Aesop's fables, fable stories, animal stories, moral stories, Aesop's fables, and note down the difficult words and phrases. Use a dictionary and write down the basic and advanced uses of those words. Here I have given, I will share the file, PDF file, along with this video. So download it and open it and refer, study, read them. And identify the words, the difficult words, and note it in your notebook and refer dictionary and write the meanings, parts of speech, word class, origin, everything. So the first one is the eagle and the arrow. Second, the swallow and the other birds. The frogs desiring a king, in that way. Okay. I think all of you understood what I explained in this chapter. So once again, if you do not understand, please repeat it again and again, understand it, and write down all activities in your notebook. Not only activities, the main advantages of a dictionary, uses of a dictionary, how to locate a word in a dictionary. All these things you have to write in your notebook, learn them, practice them, whatever I explained in the activities. And still, if you have any doubts, when I come to the live session, and definitely you can ask me, I will clarify them. Until then, I will take leave now. Thank you very much. Bye.